Welcome to the Solar Energy Channel, where you'll get an honest inside look at all things solar. I'm Warren.
And I'm Larry.
And in this video, we're going to talk about how much snow load and wind load can solar systems handle. So Larry, how much wind and snow can a system handle?
Well, it really depends how it's built and how it's designed. I mean, there were some systems in the recent hurricane in Florida that made it okay. Yeah. There was a carport that was fine. There was a roof-mounted system where some of the panels were damaged and some blew off. In our area here, typically we design around wind loads between 90 and 130 miles per hour and snow loads between 20 and 60 pounds per square foot. So wind loads are going to be higher as you get closer to the coast. Sure. So the Maryland Eastern Shore, it's going to be a higher wind load. On the other hand, with snow loads, it's going to be higher the farther north you go. So like northern New York, you're looking at 60, 70 pounds per square foot in some cases.
So what do we take into consideration when we're building a ground mount array in terms of wind and snow loads?
The best thing that we can do is just design according to the requirements of the AHJ or the authority having jurisdiction, the county, the township, whatever the authority is, they'll typically give us the design wind and snow loads that we need to build around. And we'll make sure that we let our manufacturers for the racking structures know that so that they're designing and building the systems to spec.
All right, Larry, so let's talk about roof mounts.
Yeah, so it's the same thing. I mean, we need to make sure that the system is built to spec, wind and snow load required by the AHJ and the local enforcement agencies. But we also need to make sure that we're considering what we're mounting on, because a metal roof is going to have different attachments than a shingle roof. We need to make sure that it can handle the wind uplift, the snow pushing down either way on those systems. And then a ballast mount is even different yet. A ballast mount has modules that are tilted. It has a wind deflector in the back to deflect that wind. We need to make sure that we weight it down enough that you don't have panels blown off the roof. And again, we'll get all this stamped by an engineer.
And that adds additional weight load as well, the balance. Correct. So you got to take that into account. And also it's good to know that on every roof mount structure that we sell, we have a third-party structural engineer give us a stamp of approval that that structure has the structural integrity to handle the additional weight load of the panels as well as the snow. In that area.
Right. We always want to give our customers the extra peace of mind that an engineer has looked at the structure to make sure it can handle the weight load, that they've looked at how we're going to attach it, that they've looked if it's a ground mount or a carport, they've looked at, you know, how far our piers are going down to the ground, what concrete we're using, how big the structure is to make sure that everything holds up in a wind or snow event. The other important piece here is that the modules themselves need to be rated for the proper wind and snow load. Because you've got two rails in your modules, you've got space in between where the module needs to be able to handle the wind coming up or the snow coming down without breaking. And so we take that all into consideration as well.
And you can find that information on the spec sheets for each solar module.
Correct. That's right.
Yeah. If you'd like to learn more about how we attach to different types of roofs, metal, shingle, or ballast mounts, there'll be a link to a video in the description below. Thanks for watching. We hope you found this valuable.